Hello, welcome to Back in Blue episode 56. This is how we do on the Bib Network. My name is Nick Hansen. Thank you once again for joining us. Andrew, Reid, boys, how you doing?
Hello.
Doing good.
Very well. What was that accent down there?
I don't know. I talk like this now.
Oh, I thought it was a little cheerio.
Hello.
A little bit of everything.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Why not? Boys, we're coming off a tough game today, but we had a bit of a winning streak going on. We had three wins in a row. I think Drew had the broom ready today for the sweep. Was that your broom that you tweeted a picture of?
Yeah, I made that broom a while ago.
Okay, well, luckily you made it about 20 years ago, or you maybe found it.
Yeah, I found it in the garbage. I just cut it down and put a Blue Jay sticker on it.
Yeah, the Blue Jay sticker is gold. I suggest you check out at 77 Hendrix and look at his pictures because he tweeted that out. That was awesome. I actually crossed my mind on the way. I was like, why the hell did I not bring a broom?
Yeah.
I've always wanted to take a broom for a game for the sweep.
You know what? They hustle me every time I bring it in. They're like, they got to bring their security staff over to see if it's if it meets the requirements. But luckily, I cut it down, so it's just like the handle. He's like, no, that's good to go. Bring it on in. He was laughing.
It's just gonna be short enough.
Yeah, I guess you can't roll in there with a full broom. I mean, I guess welcome to Toronto. But no, this one's cut down, and it's been a lot of fun being really obnoxious with it over the past couple of years.
I would bring a broom and actually just start sweeping.
Yeah, like clean the aisles.
Like cleaning. Like, look
excuse
at
me, you got peanuts in the way there.
Auditioning for a job.
I think the best story I had with it, I had it on the field, and this was a game against the Orioles way back when we used to beat them a lot. And
those were the days.
I don't know if you remember when Adam Jones got held up at the border and couldn't play that Friday game. And he came in on Saturday, and he was on the field.
Yeah, it kind of sounds familiar.
This is a long time ago. Okay. And he walks onto the field, and it was like picture day, right? Where everybody's on the field, the fans. And I move over, and I got this obnoxious broom in my hand, and he comes out with one of the hitting coaches, and I'm like, rubbing his face. And I think he actually ended up going 1-for-3 that day.
Wait, what did you do?
Were you in his head? Or, yeah,
well, I don't know. I just
can we get that?
I just kind of had like the broom. Imagine this was like. I used to be a lot more obnoxious than I am now, boys. So
I don't know. You're rocking that ring last week or the week before, so I think you still got it in you. All right, this has been the longest intro ever, so we're going to roll right into Jace Trendon. Leading off, we're going to talk about the 18-inning game. I didn't think we could do it, but we surpassed the 17-inning game. We lost the 18, and we got the W.
Yeah, yeah.
How good is that?
Awesome.
It is awesome. Drew, once again, you soldiered on. You lasted it out.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, this game was a lot like the game in San Diego.
Where,
you know, it's like we said before, it's really tough to win those games when you're the road team.
Yeah,
and,
luckily,
the Blue Jays had those breaks, you know, that pickoff attempt or whatever you really want to call that on Bonifacio. And then the little slap, well, I guess it wasn't really a slap, but a little charge down the third baseline from Davis there, which, I mean, it was great to win that game. But again, it's easier to win those games when you're on the home side. Mm.
Yeah, when I saw we're in the 13th inning, I was having a baby barbecue for my brother-in-law, and we had the game through the screen on the window, so we could barely even see it. It was like the worst standard definition ever because it was already a standard FTV. And so we were keeping track inning by inning. When we got to the 13th, I was like, home team's gonna win.
Yeah,
you know, I had that feeling because I knew how we had lost the 17th, right? Mm. So how about Burley though? He went 7 strong.
Mm-hmm.
Lincoln went 4 strong. Got demoted immediately.
Yeah, how's that working?
Just the world of baseball. It's a business. I mean, Reid, where do you want to start off? There's so many things that happened in the game. I mean, it was great.
Well, unfortunately, I was at a CPR course for the start of the day, so I missed half the game. Then once it got into extras, I was like, all right, I'm going to get to see some ball here because I missed literally 80, 90% of the game. And then I had a baseball game that night at 6 o'clock. So I saw like about four innings. I think I had to shut off the radio at 15th inning. So I was like, oh, I want to find out. Then I asked my girlfriend after the game, okay, do you know who won? Then I'm like, don't tell me. Then I'm like, okay, tell me. No, don't tell me. There's no Jason 30 tonight. And then I'm like, who won? Do you know? And she wouldn't tell me. I'm like, I know who won. Jays won. They're home. They got this one.
Yeah.
And then she's like, I don't know. And then I got home, found out they won. So that's honestly about all I saw from that game, unfortunately.
Yeah. And how about Jansen? First blown save?
Yeah, man. I hate to see that streak get blown. But, I didn't see it, unfortunately.
Yeah, man.
Like,
what are you,
bringing
like two
all
runs
kinds
on?
Of information today, I am. But
Well, he led two runs, two hits, and a walk, and it was obviously his weakest outing this season.
Yeah.
Drew, you've been pumping him as I have. Obviously, Jansen's been pitching great.
Yeah.
I mean, it's about time, would you say? Or, I mean, what's the deal?
This is baseball. Nobody's perfect. Nobody's Jose Valverde isn't even Jose Valverde. If you go back to a couple of years ago.
Gagne.
No, he's... It's bound to happen, and you know, luckily I think he got burned a little while ago too, and I think his line was luckily today it didn't hurt the team. And although you may contest that it maybe hurt the team today on for the Sunday game of that, because we had a weak little bullpen there, but you know, inevitably the team was able to rally behind them, albeit a number of innings later, and eventually take that game. So
Yeah, and I wanted to actually point out, you mentioned Davis. He had the winning hit down third base, but did you see the screen cap someone posted? Because the pitch before, the third baseman was eating line. He was all over it.
Oh, yeah.
And the next pitch, he'd go three or four feet over, right down the line.
That hurt.
I don't know who made that call, but I'm pretty sure it'd be the infield coach, probably giving him little signals there, telling him to move over.
Yeah,
it's unfortunate. That's how baseball goes. But 16 runners left on base, 2-for-17, runner scores in position. Obviously, you're not going to win many ball games like that, but we pulled it out. Felt good to see the W.
Yes, sir.
How about Josh Johnson? 2 starts. He had a loss against the Giants, but he pitched great. And he had no decision today, and he also pitched. He pitched all right. He had a couple long innings, high pitch counts. But it's good to see him back. How's that feel? You happy to see him back in the lineup and see him perform well?
Anytime you can get a guy like Josh Johnson back in the lineup, I mean, it's nothing but good for your team. I think we're starting to see now maybe the Josh Johnson that we were supposed to see. I don't think he's as hurt. I know he had a blister problem today, but he said that didn't affect his fastball.
Well, is that why the trainer chased him into the tunnel? Apparently, I saw on Twitter that like he went in the trainer followed him in, and it sounded like there was maybe something wrong.
I'm not sure. I had an obscured view of the tunnel from 524.
Okay, Brad's giving us a head nod. That is what it was. Drew was sitting behind the light fixture. It was like down here. He could barely see.
I love those seats.
That's a great place to be. But Johnson, now the real question is, past all the numbers and that, is he going to be traded? Is he trade bait? Do you see us at this point now, AA, thinking we need to cut ties because he's going to be too much money in the offseason? Or do you think he's going to hold on to him still and see if we can turn it around? Vote? Opinions?
It's tough. I don't know.
I didn't want to talk about it before because I didn't want to just get your initial response. Like, I can't decide either.
Not only do I not know, I don't know what the right thing to do would be either. I hope you have more of an opinion on this because I'm honestly, I don't know.
They're talking like, what's the numbers, like 5 years, 90 mil or something like that? I mean, does he deserve that when he's so injury prone or questionable?
He's, at what rate can you really justify giving him that type of contract given his recent run-in with injury problems? And I don't even mean just recent, I mean his entire career. I think he would be best suited to maybe sign a one-year type deal, two-year type deal, club option type deal where he can go out and pitch well and then kind of bolster up his expenses there, because really I don't see him having a lot of value right now. I don't think he's that $90 million pitcher that maybe he thinks he is. And
him, you know, and his agent think they are.
He could be. This is the thing. He could be. But given the track record of injuries, he can't really command that and expect to get that. So I think it'll kind of be like what the Blue Jays did with Melky Cabrera. They signed him on to a really, you know, short deal, you know, 2 years or whatever. And it cost him a little bit of money. But at the end of the day, he's going to hit the free agent market again. I think that might be the same route that Josh Johnson.
So you think AA should sit it out or like wait it out and hope he gets that contract, like a option at the end of the year? Or do you think he would work out now? Because, I mean, you can't just go into free agency and risk losing him. I think you have to make the move.
I'd lowball him on a contract extension after maybe a couple more starts, you know.
Yeah, like get the negotiations going.
Because it was the contract extension that everybody really wanted at Johnson to begin with. And I think he's kind of pitched himself injury-wise into that situation where I think a contract extension is maybe the best way you can go at this point.
All right, now we're going to go on to another hot topic for, I think, a year and a half now. Every single episode we seem to talk about him. Ricky Romero! Yeah, I mean, we're going to talk about him. He's not with the ball club right now, but he's scrapped the mechanic overhaul. He's decided, or maybe he's had an epiphany or something, but it's been a mental struggle. He's admitted it finally. Is it too late? Is it what he should have done a long time ago? Is it just good that he finally admitted it's been a mental thing? And like, how bad does the club look, or how bad does it look when he's scrapping the club's changes? That's a lot of questions.
How bad does it look on the club? Or
Does it look bad on the club? How would you feel? I don't know. I'm asking a lot of questions.
I don't think he does. My first, let's just get it all. First, my first reaction was great. He's scrapping it. I'm sure he's thought this out thoroughly, and this is a decision that he feels he should do. That's a confident decision. You don't make that and not be confident to say, I'm done with this mechanical changes that you guys are trying to put on me and going back to my old self and just trying to throw. The problem is mental. I just got to get my confidence back is essentially what he said. And I think that's a great step. I didn't expect it yet, but I can't. It's to the point where you say, well, I just want to see this guy trying everything he can making decisions that will hopefully lead him towards getting himself back. And I think this wasn't too bad of a choice at all, especially when you see his first line, his first game pitching was not too bad at all. Very promising. And it's kind of funny. I didn't really think of this when they were talking about all the mechanical changes. I'm like, I hope he adapts to these changes. His coaches, pitching staff, pitching coach is going to know what they're doing with him here. But as soon as he said, I'm going back to my old self, I'm like, yes, why didn't I think of that? Just once it's not working, just do it because you've had success. Like, they're kind of doing the whole around the block thing and haven't found any success, so they're really at the end of their rope, though.
They were, I agree.
So it's like more pressure, but I don't know. I'm starting to feel a spark of maybe this guy here is right about Ricky Rowe, but we'll see.
He's gonna come back. I know it because I put him down a couple weeks ago. Yeah. I know I put him down quickly, but I mean, it's just I've lost all faith. I mean, Ricky Rowe has been an ongoing discussion, and it's just driven us crazy since he was 8-1 because it's been completely downhill. And Reed's right. He's looking a little better, but I mean. What does that really tell you?
Oh, he's got a lot to prove.
He does.
Well, let me ask you guys this. If you're going out there and you're doing something that you've never done before, how confident are you going to be when you start getting shelled?
Not very. And you already got confidence issues.
Yes. You already have confidence issues. Now, I think originally there's a mindset that maybe these mechanical changes were to kind of masquerade some more issues that he had mentally. Yep. And maybe thinking that if he could get himself around these mechanical changes, maybe he would possibly blame that for his lack of success. I think the team realizes that maybe that wasn't the best way to go. Who knows if that's even the case? Mm-hmm. But you know what? He scrapped those mechanical changes. He went down. He threw the ball very well on Friday.
Did he have any walks? I know it was a good stat line.
I want to say it was 3 walks.
But he started really strong, and then I think he went 4 innings without a walk.
It's not necessarily the walks that you want to concern yourself. It's the way he pitches after the walks, because that's the mental game of baseball right there. And I think he showed a little bit of moxie on Friday. Mm-hmm. And who knows? Go back to those across-the-body mechanics, and you never know what you're going to find out.
Yeah.
All right. We got lots of places to go because we got lots on the list, but I forgot to mention, it's Jose Reyes Figurine Day. Ooh. Check it out. You guys obviously noticed he's on the table. Pretty cool. We got to discuss him real quick. So we talked about the Edwin bobblehead. Yep. Pretty slick. Reed?
Yeah.
He's got a pretty sweet Under Armour logo. He's got some big feet.
I was just going to say, you got a big Ronald McDonald foot. I love him.
He's solid though, right? Good giveaway.
Yeah, man. I think I'm going to grow my goatee out like Reyes. I don't know if
Why
can
not?
That.
I think you should grow your goatee like Reyes there and your hair like Drew.
Yeah. It can be done.
Good luck, Price.
Can be done.
That would be cool. No, I got to give props because that's two new figurines, bobbleheads. They're from a new company, like we mentioned, and they're looking good.
Yep.
We gave our other one away, just don't break it.
Don't put them on the DL. Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
No kidding.
And Reyes is also signing autographs. He signed autographs, and he jogged back into the dugout, and I was like, that's amazing. Just seeing him run.
Stop that.
this guy's got to settle down over here. Almost we're going to get a break. We're going to come back and talk about Jose Bautista and his ongoing complaining.
Maybe they gave him a swollen ankle.
Welcome back. Here we are, back in blue, episode 56. We're still laughing about the Jose Reyes figurine because we just noticed his legs are slightly different and there's many other funny things about him. I love the tattoo on the arm.
Yeah.
But we're going to dive right into the Jose Bautista talk. Bautista, I believe, is 3-for-3 today before he decided he didn't like the first strike called on him in the ninth. I heard it was a strike by Wilner. I didn't see the pitch tracks. Okay, it was definitely a strike. He said it caught the bottom of the zone. Mm-hmm. So obviously I believe that. You guys said it. But how bad does Bautista look? I mean, it's one thing to get tossed after, but throwing your equipment on the field.
Yeah.
You know, I can think of many words. I don't want to disrespect him, so I'm not going to say too much, but it's not right. You know, Jerry Howarth has called him numerous times the greatest leader in Blue Jays history. Do you think he's a leader when he's doing things like that? Or the greatest leader?
He's not the greatest leader in Blue Jays history. He might be he's got the team on his shoulders the most with real and things. And so he might be the most important, as in, how do I say this?
Important figure at the time?
Yes,
or
yes.
Almost like a Halliday, like a Doc. Yeah. Doc was like that pitching. Yeah.
He's not their greatest leader. He could be their most important leader. I'm not sure if I can...
Maybe it's because the guys
that
follow him so well, because of a lot of the, a lot of the Dominicans and that, mm-hmm. and maybe it's just because that he also said this before there's a lot of Dominicans on the team, so maybe it's just he thinks the guys are following him more, but I don't quite get it either, because Bautista has shown a lot of signs where he's not really being that leader.
Yeah, he should be more of the leader, and he's made a lot of errors in judgment.
Yeah. You
know? I don't know. If you want to talk about the leader talk, I mean, you have to ask yourself, who is that leader? I mean, Dave Steeb, who's going to stare down his teammates when they make errors? I don't think that's very good leadership.
You're talking about all-time
leader? Yeah. I mean, George Bell, who's going to tell off the coach, the manager all the time, that's not leadership.
And I mentioned Doc, who isolated himself
he was a recluse. I mean, who knows what he's like necessarily around the team from a leadership standpoint. Now, doing the stuff he's doing with the umpires, that's not leadership.
And no, there's
no place in this game for that. And don't get me wrong, I get on the umps just as much as anybody else. But in that situation, I don't really think he had the right to blow up on him. I mean, unfortunately, you got a guy in Bautista who had 3 hits in all of June coming into today. Now, he matched that total today with another 3 hits, and now he's got 6 hits in June, but this is 34 at-bats.
Yeah, so was he entitled? Did he think he was entitled to a ball? You know what I mean?
If you look at that, he's only struck out 4 times over that span. So really, his bread and butter is his eye at the plate. And it's like how Adam Lind is adjusting and starting to hit now, because he showed that he can get a good eye at the plate. You know, he's gonna be there, and he's going to be that guy who's going to continue to look. But unfortunately, I think you're just starting to see him crack a little bit, because I know at that point in the game, he's feeling like, well, 3-for-3 today. This is the game. Obviously, it was.
2 runners scoring position.
Absolutely. This is the game on the line. And unfortunately, he wasn't able to do anything about it. I think he was more upset with himself. And I think he kind of took it out on the umpire.
I think it was selfish. It was just a selfish move, being upset with himself.
Yeah, like he watched the first one. He wasn't happy. He chirped, told the ump it was BS, I'm pretty sure. He didn't get tossed. The umpire let him, you know, umpire probably could have tossed him the first time, because he was challenging him. I don't know what he said, but he's challenging balls and strikes. That's the rules. And then he tried to check swing the second one.
He went around.
He went around, clearly. But, you know, he was probably just, like you said, frustrated with himself at that point, right? He let the first one get in his head. And that's what he does. He lets everything get in his head. Even the one he gets put down on his back, that gets in his head, and he goes yard on the next one. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't matter what it is. He either gets jacked or he gets pissed. And
he's an emotional guy, and they all are. And again, you know, you want to talk about leadership. It's not to say that emotion isn't a good thing. It's a great thing to have, but it's picking and choosing your spots when to exhibit said emotion, really. And in that situation, I don't think throwing a tantrum on the field the way he did. And I'm not calling him out. I hate to do this, but it's not acceptable. Now, on the umpire's credit, the next at bat against Encarnacion, there was a very, very close pitch on the inside corner of the plate that he inevitably ruled a ball. I want to give him credit for that, because as we've seen in the past, umpires who think that, you know, he's getting shown up by anybody on the team, they'll take that out on your teammate. You don't care. And he held up on that call. Now, maybe that's to send a message. Who knows? But I want to give him the respect required for that, because he made hopefully the right call. I never saw that pitch exactly, but it was a very close pitch. I didn't see where it ended up on Brooks baseball or anything like that.
Well, the umpires did a good job on the every call. As soon as I saw a check swing, I'm like, I know he's getting called, even though he went no problem. Here's the problem, though. Bautista, like, you didn't want to call him out. I'll call him out from a mile away, because I'm just a nobody fan. I don't even care if we're going over on time right now. Bautista needs to get called out. This is BS. What he did today was absolutely ridiculous, and I'm telling you guys right now, if I was a teammate of his, which I would never be, unfortunately, I'm not trying to big shot myself, but I would not want to play with a guy like that. I've seen him do it too many friggin' times. It's inexcusable. We put him on a pedestal because he's our leader, and I'm sick of it. I don't think that the umpires have rung him up all the time because of his attitude, but seeing this stuff today, especially what he did today in that situation with guys on second and third with one out, and you want to get that pissy at the first pitch?
Yeah, that
give
was
me a
much.
Break.
That was a bit much.
We all agree that it's inexcusable, but I am like furious with him at this. This is completely unacceptable.
Personally, I wasn't even as pissed about getting tossed because like he wasn't happy, whatever. It was in his head. He got tossed. He chirped. He made his point, but it was the throwing of the equipment. That was you know, that's where you get into the childish games. It wasn't just he threw it. He got to the top. He had to stop to take out his arm pad, step back, and throw it back on. You know what I mean? Like, it's just so exaggerated.
It was a distraction to his whole team. Yeah. It was pathetic.
And what happened last time where we still went on to win the game? Brett Laurie was chirping the third base. Luckily, that wasn't a distraction.
Yeah.
But you know, today we didn't overcome it.
No, that was a distraction back then.
Well, it was too, but we still overcame it. You know, or the team still overcame.
I'm telling you, man. Bautista does this stuff. That's our team leader. I don't want to play with a guy like that.
It's frustrating.
Period.
It's frustrating.
He could be a great guy 90% of the time. I don't care. You're out there to win. As far as I'm concerned, he didn't cause the loss, but he helped take the bat out of the next batter's hands, and it was brutal. I can't get over that kind of attitude, man. Prima donna. Oh.
Reed's disgusted.
It's bad. Somebody's got to say it with authority.
Well, I got one more question before we'll wrap this segment up quick, because we got a lot more to talk about, and there's not much more we can say because we already expressed ourselves. But is it ever going to end? Can we expect him to maybe get a mouthful from Gibby today?
You know, no, it's not going
to
end.
Is anyone going to say anything?
Bautista's a veteran, man. He's like that.
It is what it is.
He's been like this for years. He had a reputation when he came over from Pittsburgh of being a hot-headed guy. I mean, he's got walking away from other organizations. You want to think about the Orioles or whatever, you know. They don't want this attitude, and it's burned him in the past. And he's obviously too good of a player for it to truly burn him now. But at the same token, I don't think you're going to see this change.
Cool. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll come back, and we got lots more to discuss. Welcome back. Here we are, Bib 56, like I said last time. Quick note, I forgot to mention Jose Reyes. He could be on a rehab assignment within 10 days. Less than 10 days, Anthopoulos said, so that's great news. You guys happy about that, obviously.
Yeah.
Do you think when he comes back, he's going to be that big shot in the arm that he's maybe going to help us get some Ws?
I think he's absolutely going to help us get Ws. I think he's going to merge back into his top playing form very quickly.
Yep. You see that happening? Drew?
I think he's going to be an infectious guy, and to say that, I mean, he's been around the club this entire time, and I think that speaks volumes as it is, but wait till he starts going out on the field, and, you know, really, you want to talk about a guy carrying a team and getting a guy on his back, he's definitely going to be electric out there, and I'm hoping it carries through.
Maybe he's that leader that we're missing. I got a whole bunch of names to list off here, because there's a bunch of moves. Mickey Story option, Thad Weber recalled, Rajay recalled, Josh Johnson recalled, LaRoche called up, Tole called up. Is it Tole? Is that right?
Tole.
Tole. And
Foul.
I know I've said it before, but Ghost sent down because of Rajay's return, and Blanco finally DFA'd.
And you're missing Weber getting sent back down
today.
Mr. Oliver on the way back.
Oh, let me read that real quick. We got Oliver coming up. That's good. I'm happy to see
Black
him back.
Magic.
Yeah, Black Magic.
I call him the Maestro.
he's hopefully he's got his stuff because we need that. And there's a Ching Ming Wong rumors. I don't think anything's happened with that yet.
It's solidified.
It is solidified.
Welcome to your new starter. Yes.
All right. So we got Dickie Johnson.
Yeah.
Wang.
I said Wang.
Is it Wang or Wang?
No,
I've heard
Wang.
Guys do both the same both.
Bottom line is, starting rotation is starting to look like a bunch of dicks. Really.
Yeah, you had to say it. And there's lots. I said we got lots to talk about. How about Melky? We're going to hit quick points here because we do have a lot. Melky laying down a sack bunt. Wilner tried to say that there's no way in hell Gibby called that. That was Melky's decision. Do you have a problem with him pushing over two run scoring position for Bautista and Edwin?
No, giving up an out?
Because, I mean, Wilner seemed like it was a bad move.
No problem at all with that.
Well, you get your two best
in the ninth inning.
Arguably your three best hitters if they can get to Lynn. So I was sitting there in the stands. I was thinking this is great when it happened, but in hindsight, you know the way Cabrera can spray the ball, and given the fact that we were kind of rallying out there, and you know, giving away an out like that in the middle of a rally might hurt you, but it can go either way. I'm on the fence on it, really.
I think it was an effective choice, no problem with that. Especially getting taken out the away the double play ball as well.
That too, right? Exactly. Especially the way he runs.
Exactly. Yeah. Hindsight's it's easy to say it's the wrong move because we didn't win. How about Brett Laurie reported being a walking boot? That sucks. He's already 15 day DL. They're saying it could go past 15 and hopefully not to 60. He's not looking good. It's worsened.
Yeah.
Obviously. So
I'm not surprised. It's nice to see DeRosa swinging the bat well. But ankles are tough. They can be a long time. I don't know if it's a high sprain or what, but
It is a high ankle sprain.
Yeah, high we ankle got LaRoche. They're deadly. Yeah. Yep.
Quick analysis on LaRoche there, Drew, before we move on to the next one.
Well, LaRoche is an interesting guy. He originally won the third base role over Jose Bautista for Pittsburgh, and now they're playing back on the same team. So
there you go.
He's
a good tidbit.
Yeah, he's a fun guy to watch. He's more of a quad A player than he is an MLB guy, but who knows? Maybe he'll come up and he'll get a little bit of fire going. I mean, it was rough today to see him, you know, hacking the way he was, especially after popping out in his first pitch that he saw this year. But who knows what you're going to get. Don't let today fool you. He's a pretty decent player.
Yeah, R.A. Dickey, he went 8 strong in San Francisco against the defending Giants. We're 3-1 against the Giants this year. That's awesome. He got he scored around for the bunt, did the old slap, put it right down.
Beautiful.
Yeah, that's awesome. Did you see how close Panda was on that? I love he was like 12 feet away. I think you're maybe further, but he's right there. It's awesome.
Beautiful.
Helped his own cause. Went on to win it easily. He gave up a run, or it started getting a little trouble in the ninth.
I think he went 9.1.
What inning does the game end in? I couldn't even spit it out there. Yeah, but he got over 8 innings. Yeah. So
I loved his interview after that, Ray Quick, about his at-bat. He's like, I used to do that. You know, I play there.
We do that a lot now. In the National
League. Yeah, well, apparently that's, you know, like I said, again, I keep mentioning Wilner, but he's saying how they practice that every day, I guess.
Well, they do, but I loved how smooth he said it. He's like, well, you know, I had a lot of experience there. I don't think he was being conceited, but I just loved how smooth it was set out. Like, you know, that's what we do.
There is a way when Dickey talks, people listen. People love it. How about Dustin McGowan? He came back. Interesting. Put him in the top of the 10th. Mm-hmm. Pressure situation. His first game back.
Yeah.
He got strikeout. First one since 2011. So that's good to see.
Yeah. Good for him.
Now, they used him back-to-back days. And this could have been a longer topic because they said they weren't going to do that.
Yeah.
Does it come down? It doesn't matter because they had an 18-inning game yesterday. He's a big leaguer. Got to be able to go when you're ready, like they're saying today. Or is it just, you know, isn't another case of bad management, or, you know, lying, or just not telling the truth, or whatever you want to call it?
No, I think they just kind of weighed what they had in the bullpen here and weighed their advantages and said, well, we better toss him here for an inning and things should be okay.
Yeah, Johnson only went 5 for the start today, right? Yeah. So, I mean, I think it was more of Gibby doesn't have many arms. No one's really looking good. Drew, you're okay with that? See McGowan go back to back? He did it in Buffalo also.
That's the thing. He did it earlier in the week, and this is a guy that we need to, you know, walk on eggshells around. And you're right, he's a major leaguer and he needs to pitch when he's called upon. But, I really did not like the decision to put him in extra innings there in the 10th.
Surprising.
You know, you think back to 2011, they kind of grandfathered him back in. You know, they let him go out there with a fairly sized lead. And I think he ended up giving up a run in that game as well. But, he didn't do it now, obviously, but we're talking today on the home run.
Yep.
I'm not a huge fan of it, just given the injury history. But then again, I understand the fact that we're strapped for bullpen arms, especially today after yesterday. So it's a tough decision.
Mm-hmm. All right, Drew, your quick thoughts on the draft. We picked up Phil Bickford from a California high schooler. He's 17 years old. His last high school start, he got 17 straight Ks. I don't care what level you're pitching. I love seeing that. So a quick thought on Bickford and maybe some of the other arms.
Well, Bickford's a control guy. He said in his interviews that he always practiced low to away. He had to hit it 3 times before he moved on. Things like that. He's like a guy. He's going to power the ball. He's going to control it. The Blue Jays, again, went after a lot of pitchers like they normally do, despite having so many of their higher prospects ranked as pitchers. They're going to go after them. And again, the organization stuck to the fact that they're going to go after the best talent and shy away from something, you know, maybe a position player they need, or, you know, kind of refilling that pipeline. And myself, I mean, I even wrote about it. I thought that they might go and target more position players. As we've seen in the drafts before, position players have a very low chance of working out. And you never know with pitchers. Everybody needs them. You can always deal them.
Yeah, we need lots of arms, especially when we got rid of some of our better arms. There's nothing wrong with reloading. Right? I mean, those guys aren't going to be in the position that the other players were, but it's good to see some young arms in the system.
Sure.
And
always valuable.
always valuable. Now we got the, where is it here? We got White Sox and Texas coming up this week, so we're on the road. It's going to be good. Reid and I, we're trying out for Drafted. Might as well slide this in since we have a platform.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so watch our videos, vote it up. We're trying to get on TV.
Do it.
This internet stuff's fun, but we want to be on TV.
Yeah, we need a lot of help, too, to get our names out there in the viewership and exposure.
Yeah. Check us out. It's all fun. All right, back at Blue 56. That's how we do. It's in the books. Thanks for joining us.
Peace. Why didn't you try out for Drafted?
Lazy.